Hello everyone, welcome to new video from Talent Battle. In this video, I am going to solve various questions asked by Wipro during their previous exam. Before starting with the questions, if you have not subscribed to our channel yet, as we will be posting lot of questions and lot of campus updates through our channel. Let's check this question. The Sinhagad Express left Pune at noon sharp. 2 hours later, the Deccan Queen started from Pune in the same direction. The Deccan Queen overtook the Sinhagad Express at 8 p.m. Find the average speed of two trains over this journey if the sum of their average speed is 70 km per hour. So basically, this question is based on time-speed distance concept where we need to use concept of average speed. So what is the formula for average speed? Average speed is nothing but total distance traveled divided by total time taken. Now, what they have given, find the average speed of the two trains over this journey. So, average speed of two trains means we need to calculate the distance traveled by both the trains. So, what they have given, find the average speed of the two trains over this journey if sum of their average speed is 70. Now, some students may get confused that from where exactly we need to start. We need to start from here. Sum of their average speed is 70. Sum of their average speed is 70 means average speed of Sinhagad Express plus average speed of Deccan Queen is 70. Now, average speed of Sinhagad Express plus average speed of Deccan is 70. Okay. From this, what we can do? We can calculate the distance traveled by them. Now, what is the formula for average speed? Rather than writing average speed of Sinhagad, I will use the formula total distance by total time. So let me consider distance traveled by Sinhagad is X. Now, total time taken by Sinhagad Express. As you can check, Sinhagad Express left Pune at noon sharp, means 12 o'clock. 2 hours later, Deccan Queen started. So Deccan Queen started at 2 p.m. from Pune in same direction. The Deccan Queen overtook Sinhagad Express at 8 p.m. So both trains meet each other at 8 p.m. So you can calculate the time taken by Sinhagad Express. Sinhagad Express started at 12 and met Deccan Queen at 8 p.m. So total timing 8 hours. So average speed of Sinhagad Express is going to be total distance covered is X, timing taken by Sinhagad Express is 8 hours. Now, plus average speed of Deccan, distance is going to be same, so that will be X, and time taken by Deccan Queen will be 6 hours because it started at 2 and reached at 8, so 6 is equal to 70. They have already given sum of their average speed is 70. Now just we need to calculate this. 6x plus 8x, 14x is equal to 70 into 48. 8 into 6 is 48. So 14 into 1, 14 into 5, x is going to be 48 into 5, which is 240. So x is 240 km. What is x? X is the distance traveled by Sinhagad Express and traveled by Deccan Queen. Now what they have asked, average speed of two trains. So now we want to calculate average speed considering both the trains together. Here we calculated individual average speed of Sinhagad and individual average speed of Deccan. Now we want to calculate it together. So formula is going to be same. Total distance. Total distance means distance traveled by Sinhagad and distance traveled by Deccan Queen. So that is going to be 240 for Sinhagad and 240 for Deccan Queen. Divided by total time. Time taken by Sinhagad Express is 8 hours. Time taken by Deccan Queen is 6 hours. So 240 plus 240 is 480 divided by 14. So you can just calculate it. 14 into 1, 14 into 3. So 60 means 14 into 4. So 40 again will be the remainder. So that will be around 34.2. So as you can check from the option, answer is going to be A, 34.28 km. Just by using basic formula of average speed, you can solve this particular question. Now let's check this particular question based on profit loss concept. By selling an article for rupees 19.50, a dealer makes a profit of 30%. By how much should he increase his selling price so as to make a profit of 40%? Now this question can be solved by two methods. One of the method is trying to find out cost price and then calculate profit of 40%, selling price for profit of 40%. Or there can be one shortcut which you can use, like what they have mentioned. Whenever that dealer is selling at 19.50, he makes a profit of 30%. So for 30% profit, selling price is 19.50. So for 40% profit, what will be the selling price? So rather than putting any formula, just use logic. 30% profit means he will get 30% extra on the cost price. So 30% extra means I can say 130% of cost price. So I can say 130% of cost price is 19.50 rupees. Okay, because this is the selling price. So whenever he sells at 30% profit, he is getting that price at 19.50. And what they have asked, how much selling price he has to increase to make a profit of 40%. So 40% profit means he has to sell it at 140% of cost price. 140%, so suppose if I will consider it as X. So for 130 it is 19.50, then for 140 it is X. So how to calculate X? X is going to be 19.5 into 140 divided by 130. So 0 and 0 will get cancelled. 13 into 1, 6 will be the remainder, means 65. So it will be 1.5 into 14. 1.5 into 14 is 21 rupees. So new selling price should be 21 rupees. Previous selling price was 19.50 rupees. So as you can check, that particular person has to increase selling price by 1.5 rupees. Okay, so the answer for this question is 1.5 rupees. Now let's check this particular question. A mixture of 40 liters of salt and water contains 70% of the salt. How much water must be added to decrease the salt percentage to 40%? So total what they have given, a mixture is of 40 liters. So just let me write it down over here, 40 liters. And it contains salt and it contains water. Now, what is the next part? It contains 70% of the salt. So 70% of 40 is nothing but 28. You can calculate it orally also, because 10% of 40 means 4. So 70% means 4 into 7. Or you can do it like 40 into 70% is salt, means 70 by 100. 0 and 0 will get cancelled. 28 will be salt and remaining 12 liter will be water. Now what they have said, how much water must be added to decrease the salt percentage to 40%? So right now salt percentage is 70%. We want to make sure that salt percentage is 40% in that particular mixture. So current 28 quantity which we are having should be 40%. So if 28 is 40%, then that mixture should be, suppose if I consider it is 100%, so quantity of mixture is going to be, you can do it orally also, if 28 is 40%, then 100% means it should be 70. Or you can calculate it like X is equal to 28 into 100 divided by 40. So 0 and 0 will go, 4 into 7, this will be 70. So what they have said, whatever quantity of salt I am having, that was 28, it should become 40% of total mixture. That is the reason I have considered 28 is now 40%. So what will be 100% quantity of mixture? That should be 70. So new quantity of mixture is 70. Out of that, salt is 28. So what will be the quantity of water? Initially, water was 12. And initially, as you can check, mixture was 40. So to make it 70, I need to add 30 liters. So to make it 70, if I need to add 30 liters, I need to add water 30 liter extra. Then water will become 42. So the answer for this question is 30 liters. After adding 30 liters of water, salt will become 40% in that mixture. Now let's check this question. To earn extra profit, a shopkeeper mixes 30 kg of dal purchased at rupees 36 per kg and 26 kg of dal purchased at 20 rupees per kg. What will be the profit that he will make if he sells the mixture at 30 rupees per kg? As you can check, shopkeeper mixes 30 kg of dal, which is at a price of 36 rupees per kg. So cost price of the first type of dal, you can say, is 30 into 36, which is 1080 rupees. Then 26 kg of dal purchased at 20 rupees per kg. So again 26 kg of dal is purchased, which is at 20 rupees per kg. So 26 into 20, which is 520 rupees. So as you can check, total cost price in this particular case, first type is of 1080 rupees and second is 520. So it will be 1600 rupees. So total cost price, as you can check of dal, is 1600. Then what has happened? What will be the profit that he will make if he sells the mixture at 30 rupees per kg? So now he is going to sell that mixture at 30 rupees per kg, and the mixture, the quantity of mixture is going to be 30 plus 26, which will be 56 kilogram. So 56 kilogram at 30 rupees per kg, which is 1680 rupees. So as you can check, total selling price in this particular case is 1680. So cost price was 1600 and selling price was 1680. So answer in this case is going to be 80 rupees profit. Now let's check question based on boats and stream concept. A boat takes 90 minutes less to travel 36 miles downstream than to travel the same distance upstream. If the speed of the boat in still water is 10 mph, the speed of the stream is. Now, as you know, whenever we are solving boats and stream concept, we can consider speed of boat in still water as U. Okay, so this is speed of boat now, which is in still water. Speed of stream we can consider as V, which we need to calculate. Now, what they have given? A boat takes 90 minutes less to travel 36 miles downstream than to travel the same distance upstream. Now, whenever you are going to face questions based on time, speed, distance, boat, stream or train, what you can do, try to create a basic equation. Now, what do I mean by equation? Here, what they have given, a boat takes 90 minutes less to travel 36 miles downstream than to travel the same distance upstream. So, I can say time taken by the boat to travel downstream is 90 minutes less than the time taken by the boat to travel upstream. So time taken by downstream is time taken by upstream minus 90 minutes. This is the equation which they have given. And once you understood this particular equation, it will be very easy for you to solve this question. So time taken by downstream is time taken by upstream minus 90 minutes. Now, time taken by downstream is nothing but time is distance by speed. So what I will do, rather than writing down time, I will use the formula of distance by speed. So downstream distance, in this case, boat is going to cover, which is 36 miles. So distance is 36. And divided by speed. As you know, downstream is nothing but when the direction of boat and the direction of river is same. And in that case, downstream speed is usually speed of boat plus speed of water, which is speed of stream. So I can say distance divided by U plus V is equal to time taken by upstream. Time taken by upstream, again, I can use distance as 36 miles. And while the boat is going upstream, the usual speed is U minus V because the direction is against each other. So I can write it like U minus V. And minus 90 minutes, I need to convert it into hours because it is in mph, miles per hours. So just in this case, what they have given, speed of the boat in still water is 10. So U is equal to 10 they have provided. So let me just write it down. 36 divided by 10 plus V is equal to 36 divided by 10 minus V minus 3 by 2. So now I need to solve this particular equation to get value of V. But rather than solving it by normal method like multiplying this, usually what you should do whenever you get such equation, directly use value from option. Okay, it will save your time. So suppose the first option is 2. So if I put value of V as 2, what will happen? 36 divided by 12. 10 plus 2, that is 12, so it will be 3. And on this side, what will happen? 36 divided by 10 minus 2 is 8 minus 3 by 2. So if you solve this, what will happen? It will be 36. Suppose if I make a denominator as 8, I need to multiply it by 4. So that will become 12. 36 minus 12, 24. 24 by 8 is 3. So as you can check, left hand side is equal to right hand side. So my answer is going to be 2. So rather than solving it completely, you can use option and save your time. We will be uploading some more videos based on the logical reasoning and verbal ability questions asked by Wipro during their previous year exams. Many students were asking us, can they still join our preparation package for Wipro, like silver package and gold package? Yes, you can definitely join.
Whatever the live trainings you have missed till now, you'll be getting a recorded session for that, which you can watch later on. Wipro has not provided final official confirmation on dates yet, but you can consider around 8 to 10 days are remaining for the final test. If you have not started with your preparation yet, I would recommend you to join our silver package or gold package. Give your 100%. I would again like to tell you, in silver package and gold package, the test packs which we are providing, For all the questions, we have provided test solutions like video solutions as well. If you have not joined our Telegram channel yet, I have shared a link in the description box. Even I have shared link for silver package and gold package as well. You can check details for that. I would like to tell you to join our Telegram channel as well as follow us on our Instagram channel, because many time what happens, some companies provide really less time to do registration, so it should not happen that you're missing on some important updates. Do click on the bell icon also for YouTube channel, and if you like this video, then click on the like button. Do share this particular video with your friends as well. Now, important part, if you want us to create same videos for some other companies like previous year questions, do comment on this particular video with that company name. In upcoming days, we will be uploading video for that company as well. Thank you.